Hi, what's poppin'? It's your boy Big Rich, Queens, New York City, Friday evening business. Gentlemen, come on in, wipe your feet on the rug, throw some smoke in the atmosphere. I just lit up a little bit of runts. Today in Mafia history, something new that was starting on the platform, as Big Rich does, always coming up with ideas, right? So let's get right into it. Today in Mafia history, on October 23, 1935, Dutch Schultz was shot down and killed. Let's get right into it. Dutch Schultz, born Arthur Simon Flegenheimer, was an American mobster based in New York City in the 1920s and 1930s. He made his fortune in organized crime-related activities, including bootlegging and the numbers racket. Weakened by two tax evasion trials led by prosecutor Thomas Dewey, Schultz's rackets were also threatened by fellow mobster Lucky Luciano. In an attempt to avert his conviction, Schultz asked the commission for permission to kill Dewey, which they refused. When Schultz disobeyed them and made an attempt to kill Dewey, the commission ordered his murder in 1935. As the defense costs to fight his tax case mounted, Schultz had found it necessary to reduce the commission he paid to those running his policy rackets in order to bolster what he called the Arthur Flegenheimer Defense Fund. Very quickly, the cash flow dried up, and Schultz was forced to back down, which permanently damaged the relationship between his gang and their associates. Bo Weinberg, Schultz's chief lieutenant, was so concerned about the amount of money that Schultz was taking from the rackets to fund his legal defense that he sought advice from Longhi's Willman, who put him in touch with the Sicilian-born gangster, Charlie Lucky Luciano. The deal that Weinberg wanted was to retain a percentage and keep overall control of the Schultz gang. However, Luciano planned to break up the gang's rackets and territory among his own associates once Schultz was convicted of tax evasion. Believing that a guilty verdict was a foregone conclusion at the second trial, Luciano and his allies implemented their plan to take control. Their plan met little resistance because of the ongoing bad feelings over the attempted pay cuts and the support of Weinberg. However, after Schultz was acquitted, he quickly arranged a meeting with Luciano through the commission to clarify the situation. Schultz even converted to Catholicism to cozy up to Luciano. Luciano placated Schultz with the explanation that they were just looking after the shop while he was away to ensure that everything ran smoothly and that full control of his rackets would be returned to Schultz once the heat died down. Publicly, Schultz was forced to accept that version of events because of the ongoing attention from law enforcement agencies and Thomas Dewey, now a special prosecutor appointed by Mayor LaGuardia. A month after his acquittal, his own chief lieutenant, Bo Weinberg, was never seen again after he had walked out of a Midtown Manhattan nightclub. Schultz had proposed to the National Crime Syndicate, a confederation of mobsters, for Dewey to be murdered. Luciano argued that Dewey's assassination would precipitate a massive law enforcement crackdown. The commission later voted unanimously against the proposal. An enraged Schultz said that he would kill Dewey anyway and walked out of the meeting. The Murder, Inc. leader Albert Anastasia approached Luciano with information that Schultz had asked him to stake out Dewey's apartment building on Fifth Avenue. The commission held a discreet meeting to discuss the matter. After 6 hours of deliberation, the commission ordered Louis Buchalter to eliminate the Dutchman. Schultz was shot on October 23, 1935, while he was at the Palace Chop House restaurant on 12 East Park Street in Newark, New Jersey, with Otto Berman, his accountant, Abe Landau, his new chief lieutenant, and his personal bodyguard, Bernard Lulu Rosencrantz. While Schultz was in the bathroom, two Murder, Inc. hitmen named Charles the Bug Workman and Emmanuel Mendy Weiss entered the establishment. Workman and Weiss entered the back room of the restaurant where they fired numerous times at Schultz gang members. Witnesses say Schultz staggered out of the bathroom clutching his side and sat at his table. He called for anyone who could hear him to get an ambulance. Rosencrantz rose to his feet and demanded the barman, who was hidden during the shout-out, give him some change. Rosencrantz called for an ambulance before he lost consciousness. Schultz was baptized and received the last rites from a Catholic priest at his request just before he went into surgery. Schultz lingered on for almost a day, speaking in various states of lucidity with his wife, mother, a priest, police, and hospital staff before he died. So there you have it. Again, today in Mafia history, October 23rd, 1935, they took the Dutchman down. He was a crazy guy, Dutch Schultz. But again, salute, like, comment, share. Let me know what you think of the new concept, right? And if you guys know of any dates coming up, let me know. Hit me up, mobstories87 at gmail.com. Let me just put that up there. Let me know what you're smoking on. We will talk soon. Salute.